Hi, Akin Shah. So happy to have you here
Hello,
in the interview.
Am I audible?
Yeah, you are audible. Hi, Akin Shah. Okay, very, very glad to see you here.
Thank you.
Yes. So we'd like to know from you why you really wanted to be an IAS officer.
The civil services provides me a unique opportunity to perform social service along with professional excellence. And sir, while working in the private sector, I realized that I can work for more diverse fields and more diverse areas. And sir, civil services provides me a unique opportunity in that sense. So sir, that is the reason I am aspiring to be an IAS officer.
Okay, very short and sweet. But you know, private sector is now becoming more than even the government sector. Even railways is going to be privatized. Probably airlines are already privatized. Telecommunication is already privatized. Your own field of telecommunication. So many areas are being privatized, and probably the privatization is going to be the future. So why do you really rate it little lesser than the government service in terms of opportunity? That's what you say is the reason. Yeah. Why?
Sir, yes, I agree. There are a lot of opportunities being coming in the private sector. But sir, the role of policy making and policy implementation, so that right. will be the sole responsibility of the government as such. So sir, I want to be part of that machinery which will manage such mechanisms of policy making as well as policy implementation at the ground level.
Okay, okay. Good. So that'll be nice. But now there is a lot of opposition for privatization of the railways. Okay. So, do you think it's the right move to privatize railways when there are millions of people depend upon railways for their commutation?
Sir, I think in the present scenario, government has privatized only the 5% of the railways. So, sir, the 95% of the trains that will be still controlled by the government, and their fare also, it will be decided by the government as such. So government is trying to bring a balance between attracting more and more investments and quality services from the private sector. At the same time, they are also ensuring a social obligation by keeping 25% of the trains with the Indian Railway.
Okay, okay. Can you tell me how many lines are going to be privatized as the first stage, right away? The first stage, how many lines are going to be privatized in the railways?
Sorry, sir. I'm not exactly aware of the number, but it will be around 103 trains. Those will be private.
Okay. All right. So, Ahimsa, your name itself suggests that a non-violence person. Okay. Is it the Ahimsa? Yes, Ahimsa.
I think it is much. I think it is much more wider concept than non.
Wider concept than Ahimsa. Okay. And do you know from where Mahatma Gandhi has taken this idea of Ahimsa? From where? In his own terms.
Sir, he was inspired by a Jain neighbor and his spiritual guru.
Okay.
Yes, sir. Jainism. And sir, his spiritual guru was Sri Raichand ji, who inspired him for Jainism and the core philosophy of Jainism of Ahimsa.
Okay, there are many other scholars, the European scholars, and their books and their thoughts that actually influenced Mahatma Gandhi towards this point of non-violence. Can you list out a few of them at least? Of course, many of them are inspired by Gandhi. That's a different thing. But Gandhi himself was inspired by a few writers, authors, and people who are philosophers, you can say.
Yes,
can you think about
it? He was inspired by Leo Tolstoy. Yes, sir.
Gandhi was inspired. Gandhi was inspired by a few.
Yes, sir. Gandhi ji was inspired by Leo Tolstoy.
Yes. Yes. Then Leo Tolstoy. And War and Peace.
Okay.
Correct? Am I right? War and Peace.
Yes, sir.
Author of War and Peace.
And sir, he was also inspired by Plato.
Who?
Plato's idea of idealism. So he was. Sir, Plato. The Western philosopher Plato.
Plato, okay. Plato, is he Western philosopher?
Yes,
he's a Roman. Okay, Plato. The Republic.
Yes, sir.
Student of Aristotle, student of yes, Socrates. Socrates' student is Plato. Okay.
Socrates.
Have you heard the name yes. Thoreau? Thoreau.
Yes, sir.
Rolf Waldo. There is a guy called Thoreau.
Sir, I have heard, but I am not able to.
Thoreau is a very important philosopher right? Gandhi followed. Yes. Okay. All right. So, Hari, you can take over, Hari.
Good morning, Hinsa.
Good afternoon, sir.
Yeah, it's not yet afternoon, it's still morning.
Hinsa,
suppose Mahatma Gandhi was put in a cryogenic sleep and suppose he wakes up now, how do you think that he will fit into the current state of political affairs? You understood my question?
I think he will still, yes. Sir, I think Gandhiji will still remain intact with his philosophy of politics, which he followed in the freedom struggle. So he'll still follow those ethics and he'll still suggest that politics without ethics is a dead trap. So, sir, I think he will try to clean the politics which we are witnessing in the present times and he'll inject more and more transparency and ethics in the political system as such. And sir, the politics in the Gandhi's era will be more inclusive and it will be more decentralized and it will be based on the people's participation as suggested by Gandhi, sir.
Will his policy of Ahimsa work now?
Sir, definitely it works in the present time also. Sir, in the environment sustainability, we can talk about the philosophy of Ahimsa. Sir, in the case of terrorism, climate change, global challenges which the countries are facing in the present time. So this policy of Ahimsa is very much relevant. Sir, even we are seeing
suppose the rising cases of China attacks India, should we follow the policy of Ahimsa?
Sir, since India is a peace-loving country, so firstly, our approach will be to solve the matters at the diplomatic level. But sir, if our territorial integrity and sovereignty is threatened, then even the policy of Ahimsa suggests that it is a right to go for war or for our own justice. So sir, for a greater justice, Ahimsa also suggests this because Ahimsa does not mean cowardice. Sir, it is a weapon of courageous people. So I think, sir, even in case of China, we can follow this principle.
From electronics and communication, you jumped over to political science and international relations as your optional. Why so?
So, while I was preparing for civil services, I consulted some of my seniors. And so they suggested political science and some other optionals also. So, sir, when I went through the syllabus of different subjects, sir, I found political science is interesting. So, sir, that is one of the reasons. And also, sir, the notes availability was also there as far as PSIR is concerned. So, I
did you go through any other optional? Did none of your seniors suggest any other optional?
Yes, sir. Sir, I went through public administration, sociology also. Sir, but some of the parts of the political science I found very interesting, sir, especially the IR topics and the Indian governance system and the freedom struggle part. So, sir, I chose PSIR.
What is post-truth politics?
Sir, post-truth politics is based on, sir, it is not based on facts, or rather, it is based on, where evidence is not the basis of post-truth politics and just, sir, mainly use of social media. It is influencing the politics in the present time. So, sir, this term of post-truth politics is used in that sense, where the politics is not based on reality or the facts. Rather, it is based on the whims and fancies of some particular parties or some particular individuals.
Can you mention any such examples happening in the current scenario?
Sir, the politics which Mr. Donald Trump in United States of America, as a president which he's playing right now. So I think, sir, these are based on the post-truth politics. sir, his withdrawal from various institutions and his allegations. Sir, although
coming to the
some
Donald
allegations
Trump's policy,
are true,
recently,
I am not denying
US has, coming to Donald Trump's policy, recently U.S. has withdrawn from WHO and has stopped and has blamed them for this spread of this pandemic. What is your take on that?
Sir, I think this step is unwarranted in the present time, given the globe is fighting
but do you
with
think,
the pandemic.
Again, but do you think that has WHO failed in his mandate to curb such pandemics?
Sir, I agree to a certain extent. There were loopholes in the working of the WHO as such, and there are allegations that WHO is working at the behest of China. But sir, withdrawing from the institution as such, and that too at such a crucial point, sir, and that is not a legal or ethical step by a country which is the largest contributor in terms of funds to WHO. Sir, it will impede the fight against this virus, especially in the least developing countries, African and South Asian countries. So, sir, I think US should have pushed for reforms in WHO, rather than a withdrawal from WHO.
Okay.
What does NAM stand for? NAM.
The non-aligned movement.
Is it still in vogue?
No, it's not. Hello. May not be very active now. Okay, nice. Okay.
Sir, hello. Your voice please. Is not audible.
Yeah. Sir,
okay.
No.
Krishna Khan, please
welcome.
Mr. Krishna Khan.
Yes, sir. So, Ahimsa, you are from Jabalpur, right? Which is a major city on the banks of River Narmada. Hello, are you able to hear?
Can you hear me? Yeah.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
So, can you tell me about environmental versus developmental debate on Narmada Valley project? Narmada Valley project has two components. What are those and what are positives and negatives?
So, Narmada Valley project, sir, it basically worked on creating one of the largest dams in India, Sardar Sarovar Dam, and also generating hydroelectric power from this dam. So, sir, there was a movement led by Medha Patkar, which led the World Bank to withdraw from this project also. So because of the lack of proper rehabilitation and compensation to the tribal people lying across the Narmada Valley. And sir, also there was a lot of environmental destruction also because a large forest area lied across this region. So sir, this is the all debate regarding the environment versus economy. But sir, the state government as well as the central government is working to ensure proper rehabilitation for the tribal people, and that movement has also subsided to a great extent.
So what is the developmental advantage? How much of power will be generated? How much of land will be irrigated? Do you have any statistical figures?
Sorry, sir.
Okay.
I'm not aware.
You are from electronics and communication engineering background. Now, recently there is a debate about banning Chinese imports and products from that country. So we are dependent on very much of electronic imports. Every modems, mobiles, everything is from China. At the same time, we are thinking about generating that production in India. We have a semiconductor industrial policy in India, so as to boost semiconductor industry. But we don't have proper wafer fabrication labs, semiconductor labs. So how do you think that we can compensate the imports from China?
Yes, sir. In the short term, there might be difficulties for India because we were heavily dependent on Chinese imports. Sir, but in the meantime, there are various packages by the government. Sir, recently, there is a 48,000 crore package which is being announced to boost the domestic manufacturing of these chips in India itself. And sir, at the same time, we can also diversify our imports from other countries. So we can look for other countries which are manufacturing such kind of chips. Sir, for example, South Korea. So, and sir, even various companies, sir, like LG and even other companies, Samsung, they are planning to establish their own manufacturing plants of chips in India. So, sir, in the short time, India might face difficulties, but sir, with adequate investments and adequate skilling of the youth in this manufacturing of chips, sir, we can ensure our own self-reliance.
Okay, then my last question will be, this MP has given a lot of migrant labors to various states. Recently, there was exodus of migrant labors from various states to their native states. A lot of migrant labors went back to Madhya Pradesh. What is their status now with respect to COVID and their livelihood? Because there is no jobs, there are no jobs available anywhere now.
Sir, according to MP government data, around 13 lakh migrants came back to Madhya Pradesh. So government is taking various steps. Sir, there were cash transfers by the state government to the bank accounts of migrants. Recently, commission, MP Migrant Commission has also been set up by these, and various schemes like Rozgar Setu, these are coming up so as to skill map the migrants, and employers can get the migrants to various industries. So, sir, these are the steps which the MP government is taking, and also, sir, at the national level also, there is a Pradhan Mantri Garib Kalyan Rozgar Yojana under which some of the districts of MP are also being selected. So, that also the migrants will be working. So, MP government is taking care as far as the food, shelter and job of migrants is concerned.
Okay.
Okay, thank you.
Okay. So, again, Shah, your cycling is your hobby. What kind of a cycle do you have right now? What kind of
a cycle? Sir, I have a very basic cycle of BSA Ladybird.
Okay. No gear in the cycle?
No, sir. Sir, it is a normal cycle.
What is your average speed when you cycle? How long you cycle and what's your average speed?
Hello?
Yeah. What's your average speed?
Sir, could you please repeat the question?
Yeah. What's your average speed?
Sir, it's around 12 to 13 kilometers per hour.
Okay. How many hours do you cycle?
Sir, I do not cycle based on number of hours. Sir, I use it for my daily routine purpose. Sir, like visiting friends or going to grocery store. So for that purpose, I use cycling. And sir, in the morning, no, sir.
So there are professional cycling going on all over India. There are professional cycling bodies like Autax India Limited, France Randonneurs, Super Randonneurs. Do you know about these organizations?
Sir, I only know about the national organization for cycling, which we have in India. So, okay. Sir, I'm not aware of the other organizations.
At least can you tell us some of the world well-known brands in cycling?
Yes, sir. Yes.
Like, can you tell some of the names?
Sir, Hero is there. Atlas is there.
Indian. They are Indian. Or race cycles, foreign cycles, very well known companies. Bianchi, Trek, Cannondale. No idea?
Sir, I look into it.
Okay, fine. Okay, Yensha, your interview is over. Good. You are done extremely well. Well matured, you are a good candidate, potential candidate. Very careful about very sensitive questions like why do you want to become an IAS officer? You have come out very well in that also. Unique opportunity. But only the thing is when you talk about private sector, better than private sector, then you'll have to justify that. Why private sector doesn't have any serious diversified activities? Actually, there are. So you don't have to compare the private sector. You can simply say government service is very special, very unique, and without even mentioning that.
Okay.
In a clever way. And yes, it was still morning, but you said good afternoon.
And
Hari then corrected it. Yes. No, he said no, actually it's morning.
Okay? Yes, sir.
Even now, it's still is morning. A little careful, as in, the time of the day. You should not simply say early morning. You should not go and say good evening in the morning. That's much more important. Not a problem, actually. Definitely, it's not going to reduce your mark, but you may be a little upset, and that will show in your body language. They don't mind. It's absolutely fine. But it should not show the symptom of weakness or defeat at this point in time. Sometimes, since you are from Jabalpur, they may ask you about the Jabalpur blinding case. Do you know that case?
Lynching.
Sorry, sir.
Jabalpur blinding.
That lynching case.
Not lynching. Jabalpur, there was a very famous case of dacoits were blinded. The police have deprived of their eyes. You don't know?
Oh, no, sir.
It's a very, very famous case.
I'll check this.
From police brutality, this was talked all over the world. Jabalpur blinding. Okay. Okay. Then probably in Madhya Pradesh only, the public assaulted the health workers. When the COVID pandemic fight started, it first place to assault the health workers is in Madhya Pradesh. I think in Bhopal or Indore, I don't know.
Indore. Sir, it was in Indore.
Yeah. So this can be a question. H-1B visa, because you are electronic and communication engineer, H-1B visa, it's going to impact people who are seeking job. These questions. I'm very happy that you know about Thoreau and Leo Tolstoy and Mahatma Gandhi's influence. You know, Jainism all over the world is considered to be only peaceful religion. Even the atheists like Richard Dawkins, Sam Harris, and these people keep on saying all religions are violent. All religions. Except probably Jainism.
Yes.
So they may ask why it's so and what is the principle. Nice, you've done very well. And Hari?
Ahimsa, in fact, you might be appearing before the interview board with a mask on, but I feel you can be a bit more pleasant and smiling because your appearance gives out a tensed feeling. And otherwise, you came out as a balanced person. While asking questions about this, because you have international relations as one of political science and international relations as your optional, there will be questions from international relations and maybe this COVID preparedness or COVID actions of this US and other nations. And at the same time, the failure of these international organizations and similar questions. So be prepared on those grounds. Otherwise, you were not taken aback. You could respond to all the questions positively. And all the very best. You'll do well.
Yes.
Thank you, sir.
All the best. Okay.